for the kids. Do we still have our kids with us? All right.
Okay. Good morning. I'm just happy to be here in person today and to be able to see all of you. I've missed seeing people and being in a church, and I'm happy to be able to. I'll have to look at my television audience and all of you. We thought you might be interested in learning, the children and the grown-ups might be interested in learning a little bit about how you plant something in a hydroponic system. So we're very fortunate because our daughter-in-law works for the company that makes the hydroponics tower. And about how long ago was it when we got our first tower?
Probably 5 or 6 years ago.
Yeah, so she set us up with that tower. And then this year...
Felicity has the pictures, doesn't she?
Well, wait, that comes at the end. Okay, not sorry. Yet. We got to save the surprise. when they came for Christmas this year, they actually brought the parts to 2 more towers. So we have set up our second tower, and maybe our third one will be next. But we thought you might want to know, because God is so amazing to pack so much power into a tiny, tiny seed. So how do you start when you're planting something? And when you plant with hydroponics, it's just water. There's no dirt. So how you start is, can anyone here in Brooksville guess what the first thing you have to get is? Just seeds. And you can get them at the store, or you can get them from a hydroponics company. But here, I got these at Lowe's lettuce. And the thing that's so amazing is in any package of seeds, there's so... Oh, sorry, I'm not showing the television audience. but there's so many seeds in there. In just one package, there's just so much potential, which we'll talk more about in the sermon. But anyway, so you get your package of seeds. And then... you get your, what is this called now? Rock wool. And so this is what you actually are going to plant it in. So you get a big thing of rock wool and you break it up. Okay, so now you have your piece of rock wool. I got to make sure they can see it. Okay, see how there's a hole in there. So then you take your little seed. Oh no, whoops. You soak the rock wool so that it's all wet. And then you take your seed and you put it in the rock wool, a couple of seeds. You don't want too many because it's going to go crazy. And then you put your vermiculite on the top of the seed and you give it some time so that it starts to sprout in the house before you put it in the system. Uh-oh, I'm not killing my little baby. Okay, then can you see that it's growing? I'll show this to the camera and then I'll show it to all of you. This is some romaine, and I always take a little pin and I put something on it that says what it is. And when it gets a little stronger, then you put it in a little basket and you put it in the tower. And then I'll leave this part to you to explain.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, these are the pieces of the tower. And what you do is you stack several of these down, and then there are rods that go through to lock it all into place, and a pump. There's a basin at the bottom that's filled with water, and the pump will pump the water all the way up through the top, and then it'll trickle down to where all of the things of rock wool are with the plants in them. But it isn't just that. You want me to talk about the nutrients?
Yeah, talk about all of them.
When you put the water in, you know, when you plant plants or when you plant seeds in the dirt, they get their nutrients from the ground. When you're putting plants into a hydroponic system, there's no dirt. What you have is the rock wool. But what you have to do is you have to add 2 different kinds of nutrients to the water that gets circulated up. So if the plant can't get the nutrients from the ground, then you have to supply it in the water, and the water goes up and trickles all down, and it feeds each of these little plants. And depending on the plant, they grow quite well.
So now you want to show the pictures of what happens when they finally start growing. And I think we have some pictures we sent over to Clustine to show you. So there's the tower.
That's the newest tower right there. And if the camera had shown over to the right, you'll see the parts of a third tower. But go ahead and show the next one. And that's the tower.
That's the original one.
That's the original one. I have to, whenever we're done with it, you know, some stuff just gets out of control. You clean it all up and then you reset it. And that's just been cleaned up and reset. But you can go ahead and show the next one here.
That's one of our
tomatoes. The one of the plants that does really, really well in hydroponics is tomatoes. It goes crazy every single time. And you'll see it in the next one.
It's a blurry picture, but we wanted you to get the
that
idea.
Whole corner. The hydroponics is over to the right. And it got so out of control that it took over like the whole back left side of the pool area. That's all tomato plants.
That's like one tomato
that's
plant.
That's one tomato plant that just went berserk. And you can see some of the tomatoes in there. In fact, I'll tell you another funny story about it. And that was that there were times when I couldn't get to the tomatoes in time. And I would get out there and they're kind of on the deck there, kind of rotting. And so I would pick them up and I'd throw them out back. The backyard in that house there was kind of wild territory. There wasn't any grass. There was a lot of oak trees and stuff. But I would throw the tomatoes, the old tomatoes to the left by outside the pool enclosure. And then I'd come out there like a week or two later and I would find tomato plants growing where I'd thrown the tomatoes, but you can go ahead and show
And it. Also, take a look at that one tall plant, because I'm going to reference
it. Yeah, the one
it
that has the lighter the green sermon. But this is
that
the tomato
tall
plant.
One at the end. Yeah. But anyway, you can show the next one.
But, you know, the next one's a little clearer, but that is, before it took over the left side, that was the tomato plant. There.
Which was kind of fun to swim in the pool and grab some tomatoes.
You could actually swim over and pull a tomato off the vine and eat it right there.
Yeah. But anyway, God is just amazing the way he puts the power in that little seed. And I think we need to remember that no matter what happens and how discouraged we get, we have the faith, he says, of a mustard seed. He will bless that. And I know that he's blessing all of us during these difficult times. And just like that plant can grow, our faith can grow and our congregation and our love for one another.
Okay. Anyhow, we've learned a lot about growing plants through that.